about me was that they expected this from me next year. And don't get me wrong, I'm not complaining about this, because complaining implies that I was pressured, which I wasn't, not at all, because this was all because of my skill, my grade, my choices, so nobody but me was responsible. 2 years later, I returned to this city, except everything was almost a lot more different. I almost failed a class in the seventh grade, and why now it seems like nothing, it didn't matter to me. It mattered to me, it mattered to the giant in me who was always fulfilling expectations, no matter how high they were. A year after that, I had enough. I finally ran to my parents, crying about the monster in my head, and 3 days later, I was diagnosed with an anxiety disorder. The thing they don't tell you about psychological disorders is that if you were feeling just fine before this diagnosis, you definitely won't be out. Anxiety is a funny little thing. It's almost like a spider weaving a web in the corner of your room, going unnoticed for so long, but then the day you finally spot it, it never leaves your sight. Every moment you spend in that room is plagued by the knowledge that there is a spider in the corner of that room, weaving a web that would trap its prey. But anxiety is much larger, with a stronger web, a tighter hold, a relentless chase. I think that in a way, that stupid diagnosis fucked me up more than I ever did myself. Because honestly, isn't that what all psychiatrists do? Name it something that is insanely rampant in a large population, make you feel psycho when you sit in that plastic chair. So from that moment on, before and after every exam, I could feel my brain running 1,000 miles an hour, analyzing every single possibility, and always coming up with a negative one. My brain is such a shitty mathematician. Imagine if every possibility was a negative one, Murphy would be rolling in his grave. Because if what could happen was negative, there was hardly any room for what would happen, right? It was as if I was constantly playing a game of rigged Russian roulette, with anxiety being the one holding the gun to my temple, and a bullet of fear exiting it every single time, injecting my thoughts with doubt and suspicion. And at one point, the gun just wasn't enough anymore. So it wrapped its frighteningly long fingers around my neck and left it there for months and months and months on end, stamping the positivity out of me. So every time I even thought about an exam, I collapsed under crushingly repressing self-doubt. So a word of advice to anybody with anxiety, always make sure you have a blade hidden between your fingers, so that when you know you've had enough, when you know that your expectations for yourself are not unrealistic, when you can fucking go and give that exam and leave the room with a grin on your face, and that blade between your fingers can embed itself between the ribs of that bastard, bleeding out of your mind at a speed of 5 pints an hour, so that at the end, that hand around your neck goes limp and unhooks itself, falling to the ground with a satisfying thud before vanishing into thin air. Never have I ever woken up in the middle of the night running to my parents and crying about a monster under my bed and asking them to make sure it's gone before I can sleep again. But this time, right now, the monster at the back of my mind is hardly noticeable, waiting, strategizing, not